As we head into the New Hampshire primary, we're joined now by the Republican National Committee Chairman, Reince Priebus. Thanks for joining us, Mr. Chairman.
Hi, Erin. How are you?
I'm doing well. Of course, this is a busy time for us here in New Hampshire. Mitt Romney, he's leading in our most recent poll by 41%. He topped the vote in Iowa, though only by a few votes out there. But he seems to be poised to win here. Do you expect him to be the nominee?
Well, I don't know how it's going to go. I mean, obviously, this is the start, not the finish. But what I do know is that I think the base in the Republican Party and the American people are ready to make Barack Obama one-term president. Obviously, our economy isn't where he promised it would be. And just holding Barack Obama to the standards that he set for himself, he's going to be a one-term president. And we're not just looking to do well in New Hampshire on Tuesday and having a good showing as a party. But we want to make sure that New Hampshire stays red, actually, in November of 2012. That's really where we need to do well there in your home state.
Does it concern you at all, should Mitt Romney be the nominee, that it seems that there are many Republicans, conservatives especially, who just aren't ready to throw their support behind him?
Well, I don't know if I agree with the premise there, Erin. You know, like I said before, it's early in the process. All these candidates are making their case to the base of the Republican Party. And in the case of New Hampshire, some folks that aren't always identified Republican, but at least for this election, they are. So, you know, I think it takes time, Erin. And, you know, this idea that somehow a tough primary is bad for a party, I just don't buy into it. I think tough primaries have the opposite effect in a primary, that they're good for the challenging party. Look at Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton in 2008 in your own home state of New Hampshire. I mean, Hillary Clinton had the famous crying scene. Now, she ended up doing well there, but not after some, I mean, you want to talk about punches being thrown. I think she called Barack Obama a hypocrite from the very beginning. I mean, so tough primaries don't always mean, you know, results, tough results down the road. I think it's the opposite. I think they're good for the party.
And again, here in New Hampshire, we're seeing a bit of a surge from a former member of the administration, as you know, John Huntsman.
Well, that's what I hear. And obviously, we're going to, I heard in your news program as well that there's a lot of folks that haven't made a decision. So these candidates are going to be busy for the next 2 days. And the voters there have a unique opportunity to help shape the primary season here, as they always do in New Hampshire. And I'm a big believer in the early primary states. As you know, I supported New Hampshire's position on our calendar, and I think it's a good barometer for our country.
What do you think is going to happen on Tuesday?
I wouldn't venture to guess, being chairman of the party, but I think it's going to be a good day for New Hampshire, and I think it's going to be a good day for our party and starting out this primary season on a good foot. And you all do a nice job of making it all hospitable and a good forum for everybody.
Do you think we're going to see any surprises here in New Hampshire?
Well, I'm not sure. I mean, obviously, it's been surprising. It was only been one primary so far, and there was a couple surprises there, but I think the primary is very tough to read. It's tough to poll. I think that it's difficult to determine outcomes prior to them occurring, unlike a general election. So, you know, it's not something I want to get into, but certainly we look forward to tomorrow night and the fun and the excitement that it's going to bring.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman, for joining us.
Thank you, Erin.